the base in the fill in the blank, inguinal ligament, the base inguinal ligament, the base of the triangle is formed by the inguinal ligament. We know that the inguinal ligament extends from anterior superior iliac spine to the pubic tubercle. And the mid-inguinal point is an important reference area for the femoral artery. Mid-inguinal point is always. Medial to the mid-inguinal point is related to the veil, and lateral to the mid-inguinal point is related to the nerve. One is femoral veil and another one is the femoral nerve. So mid-inguinal point is the reference point over here. So base is formed by the inguinal ligament, and next one is the medial border. Medial border. The medial border is formed by, this is the medial border. The medial border is formed by medial border of adductor longus muscle. Fill in the blank. Medial border is formed by medial border of adductor longus muscle. In this particular point, different authors mention like different sites. Some authors say that lateral border of the adductor longus, some authors say that this is the medial boundary of the femoral triangle, some authors say that this is the medial boundary of the femoral triangle. But because this is the apex, so more correct will be this one when compared to that of this angle. Okay, that's the reason many of you study the textbook. Some authors say that lateral border of the adductor longus, you'll also see in the book, but write down medial border of the adductor longus, generally concentrate for MCQ points. Next will be the lateral border. This is the lateral border. So the base is formed by the inguinal ligament. Medial border is formed by the medial border of adductor longus muscle. And next is the lateral border. The lateral border is formed by medial border of sartorius. This is the sartorius muscle. This is the medial border of sartorius, and this is the lateral border of sartorius. So the lateral boundary is formed by medial border of sartorius. This one. The lateral boundary is formed by medial border of sartorius. And next one is the apex. Apex. Meeting point of medial and lateral borders. Apex. We already have this in the book. Meeting of medial border as well as lateral border, that is adductor longus as well as sartorius. Next, let us talk about the flow. Flow. In the floor also, you have fill in the blanks over here. We will divide the floor, this is the one, we will divide the floor totally into two parts. Medial part of the floor as well as lateral part of the floor. Because after removing superficial fascia, deep fascia, even after removing all the contents which are present in the femoral triangle, you can see the floor. The floor of the femoral triangle is formed by the muscles. So the medial portion of the floor is formed by two muscles, that is adductor longus as well as pectineus. So in the floor, we have medial as well as lateral. In the medial, what you need to write is adductor longus as well as pectineus. The medial portion of the floor is formed by adductor longus as well as pectineus. Medial portion of the floor. Next is the lateral portion of the floor. This is the lateral portion of the floor. The lateral portion of the floor is formed by two muscles, iliacus as well as psoas major. So we can call it as iliopsoas. Lateral portion of the floor, iliopsoas. So the base is formed by the inguinal ligament. The medial border is formed by the medial border of adductor longus. The lateral border is formed by the medial border of sartorius. Apex is formed by the meeting point of medial as well as lateral borders. And the flow is formed by, is divided into two parts. It is formed by adductor longus, pectineus as well as iliopsoas muscles. So this is about the boundaries as well as flow. Now let us talk about the roof. Let us talk about the roof. So we know that the roof of the femoral triangle, we need to discuss from superficial to deep. If we discuss from superficial to deep, what are the structures we have? One is skin. After removing the skin, we have superficial fascia. So what are the contents of superficial fascia covering the femoral triangle? The superficial fascia contains long saphenous vein, which pierces the superficial fascia, which pierces cribriform fascia, that is a part of the fascia lata, as well as drains into femoral vein. We discussed this. So the roof is formed by skin, superficial fascia, plus its cutaneous muscles and cutaneous nerves. Because superficial fascia contains cutaneous veins, as well as cutaneous arteries. What are the cutaneous arteries we have in the superficial fascia, which is covering the femoral triangle? We discussed about the branches of the femoral artery above in the femoral triangle. We discussed about three superficial branches as well as three deep branches. The three superficial branches, why we are calling them superficial branches? Because they pierce the deep fascia to reach superficially. They lie along the superficial fascia. Superficial external pudendal artery, superficial big gastric artery, superficial circumflex iliac artery. So these are the three superficial arteries which are located in the superficial fascia covering the femoral triangle. So we have skin. After the skin we have superficial fascia, and along the superficial fascia we have superficial cutaneous muscles as well as cutaneous nerves. So this is important. And other than this, there is another content also located in the superficial fascia. Lateral femoral cutaneous nerve is also present, but we will study that lateral femoral cutaneous nerve when we discuss about the femoral sheath in detail. So the roof is formed by skin, superficial fascia, and deep fascia. In the brackets you can write cutaneous muscles, lymphatics and nerves. Cutaneous muscles, lymphatics as well as nerves. What are the cutaneous lymphatics we were discussing? We discussed about the lymphatic drainage of the lower limb. The lymphatic drainage of the lower limb is divided into three groups. Right? Popliteal group, tibial group, there is only one node called an anterior tibial node, and there are inguinal nodes, right? Which are superficial inguinal nodes. When we discussed about superficial inguinal nodes, if we go back to our lymphatic topic, we discussed that the lymphatics of the thigh or superficial group or superficial inguinal lymph nodes are divided into two groups, upper horizontal group as well as lower vertical group. If you see, if you remember, upper horizontal group is further divided into medial as well as lateral, and lower vertical, there are five in number. They are located on either side of the long saphenous vein or great saphenous vein. We have the image also very clearly. Superficial group, we have two nodes medially, three nodes laterally, and we have approximately five nodes which are located on either side of the great saphenous vein. All these are the superficial inguinal lymph nodes. So what are deep inguinal lymph nodes, which are located deep to the deep fascia? So we already studied in the femoral canal we have the lymph node of Klopfert, which is also called the lymph node of Rosenmüller, which is the deep inguinal lymph node. Okay? So deep inguinal lymph node is a content of the femoral triangle, but it does not form the structures of the roof of the femoral triangle, remember. So the roof of the femoral triangle always contains skin, superficial fascia, deep fascia, that's it. And superficial fascia contains superficial muscles, cutaneous nerves, as well as cutaneous lymphatics, right? This forms the roof. After the roof, let us talk about the contents. Contents are very, very important. If we discuss the contents from lateral to medial, sometimes in the exam they'll ask you about medial to lateral. From lateral to medial, if you see the image very clearly, the first one is the femoral nerve as well as its terminal branches. Contents, major contents, femoral nerve as well as its terminal branches. This is the femoral triangle, right? Medial border of sartorius, right? As the medial border of adductor longus and inguinal ligament, and this is the apex. So the lateralmost structure is the femoral nerve. But sometimes, if they want to ask a tricky question, the lateralmost structure of the femoral triangle is the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. See this. Lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. This one. Okay? So this lateral femoral cutaneous nerve is the content of the femoral triangle, but it is cutaneous in nature. When we are talking about cutaneous in nature, it is passing from deep to superficial. Which means first it enters into the femoral triangle, from the femoral triangle, it pierces deep fascia, it pierces superficial fascia to become superficial to give a cutaneous innervation to the skin of the lateral aspect of the thigh. That is the reason we are not mentioning it as a one of the main content. But if we specifically ask, if you have an MCQ which says that what is the lateralmost structure of the femoral triangle, if you have lateral femoral cutaneous nerve in the option, that is correct. If you don't have lateral femoral cutaneous nerve, the femoral nerve is the lateralmost and one of the most prominent as well as important structure in the femoral triangle. So the lateralmost structure is the femoral nerve as well as its terminal branches. And one of the branches you can see very clearly in the femoral triangle, the saphenous nerve is also present. Right? Saphenous nerve is the cutaneous nerve, one of the major cutaneous nerve of the femoral nerve over here. And next one is the femoral artery. So medial to the femoral nerve is the femoral artery, what you can see over here. The femoral artery, is it dividing into two branches or it is giving the main branch in the femoral triangle? Femoral nerve is dividing into two branches, right? Femoral nerve is dividing into two branches, that is anterior division, posterior division. Anterior as well as posterior division of the femoral nerve are separated by lateral femoral circumflex artery. Lateral femoral circumflex artery. Lateral femoral circumflex artery as well as medial femoral circumflex arteries, two are the branches of profunda femoris artery. Profunda femoris artery, which is also called as deep artery of the thigh. Right, one of the deep artery of the thigh, what we are seeing here, this is the femoral artery and this is the profunda femoris artery. So in the femoral triangle, what are the contents if we discuss? Femoral artery as well as its branches. Femoral nerve as well as its branches. What are the femoral nerve as well as its branches? Anterior as well as posterior division. As well as saphenous nerve, which is one of the major terminal branch of the femoral nerve. So next, when we talk about artery, we need to say that femoral artery as well as its branches. What are the branches? Three superficial branches and three deep branches. So after the femoral artery, next one is the femoral vein. Femoral vein. Femoral vein as well as its tributaries. Femoral vein as well as its tributaries. Tributary is whatever they are receiving. So what are the tributaries it is receiving? Say it is receiving like circumflex vein, it is receiving great saphenous vein, it is receiving. Everything follows the artery, remember. Last time also I explained about it. The only difference is the femoral artery is giving direct superficial branches, but femoral vein is not receiving the superficial veins directly, because superficial veins comes and drains into the great saphenous vein, and great saphenous vein is the one comes and drains into the femoral vein. So great saphenous vein, you have one of the content of the femoral triangle as well as its tributaries. So that's what we need to say. Femoral nerve as well as its branches, femoral artery as well as its branches, and femoral vein as well as its tributaries. And another important structure, you can see the uppermost structure which is covering the upper 3 to 4 centimeters of the femoral vessels, which include femoral artery as well as femoral vein, is the femoral sheath. So femoral sheath is also considered to be one of the content of the femoral triangle. So here we gave femoral vein, femoral artery, femoral nerve, and other structures which are also found. We mentioned lateral femoral cutaneous nerve and femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. Do you remember femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve? Where we studied this? Femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. Root value is L1, L2. Root value is L1, L2. Lumbar plexus. Ilioinguinal nerve. Iliohypogastric nerve. Femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. Remember, ilioinguinal nerve is directly coming from L1. Iliohypogastric nerve is directly coming from L1. Femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve is the branch of lumbar plexus, coming from L1 as well as L2. After that, we have L2, L3, L4 anterior division, L2, L3, L4 posterior division. Posterior division is giving femoral, anterior division is giving obturator. This is what, after that, the last one of the lumbosacral trunk, whatever it is forming. This is what we stated in lumbar plexus. So, femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve, lateral femoral cutaneous nerve, right? As well as the lymph node of Clopfit. We cannot see it over here, but we know The medial most compartment of the femoral sheet is called as femoral canal. Next topic is the femoral sheet only. There we will discuss in so much detail. We also have the deep inguinal lymph nodes. All these are considered to be the contents. You also have in your textbook the image. The simplified image is present. You can see it in the page number 141. See, from lateral to the medial, if you see in that image, lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh, and you can see the femoral nerve, which has anterior as well as posterior divisions, which is separated by the lateral circumflex femoral artery. And next you have the femoral artery as well as its branches. There you have femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve, which is anterior to the artery. What do you mean by anterior to the artery? And we are calling it as a cutaneous branch, anterior to the artery, which means when we are talking about genital branch of genitofemoral nerve, which is anterior to the artery, means, remember, upper part of the femoral artery is covered by the femoral sheet, which means we can say that this particular nerve is embedded in the femoral sheet. So it is one of the part of femoral sheet. Part of femoral sheet, one of the content of femoral sheet. Anyway, the femoral sheet is also a content of femoral triangle. That is the reason we are discussing this particular nerve, femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve, is also a content of the femoral triangle. Okay, when we discuss the femoral sheet, you will understand where exactly this particular nerve is located. And the medial to the, in the same image, in the medial to the artery, you can see the nerve, the vein, as well as its tributaries. And medial to the vein, you can see the deep inguinal lymph nodes. So all these are the contents of the femoral triangle. So this is the femoral triangle.